not, but he or she wouldn't, and couldn't, and no one could prevent you from testifying. So those are the real key decisions that only you can make.
He's putting it in a way that is just another way of saying, look, you've got three options. You've got one of these options. Okay? He's just putting it in a nicer way. Oh, you've got three decisions that only you can make, as if you hold the power. Oh, I hold the power? Oh, okay, then I'll go ahead and make one of these decisions because I hold the power. It's just a lame judicial tactic that he's using. He's grasping at straws at this point, trying to find any tactic that'll be effective. Because so far he's just nothing. Shooting blanks, buddy. You're relying on you're trying to force an attorney on him because you can't do it. You're hoping another attorney will be able to. They're all attorneys, whether they're wearing judge robes or not. I mean, a judge is nothing but a promoted attorney. That's a promoted manipulator and liar. That's all it is.
You can make them with or without some advice from an attorney that has legal training and experience.
Attorneys have legal training and experience? The hell you say? We can't let him waste time like this.
You may or may not have. And
this is not only stating the obvious, it's kind of treating you like you're clueless, that you're here and clueless, and we very much are not. So, objection, point of clarification, I appreciate all the information that you're giving me, Judge. I do. I know you have so many people that come through here who don't know it, but I do know this stuff, and so it's actually not new to me. I'm very familiar. I simply require evidence of jurisdiction from the prosecution. Can I have a copy of it, yes or no?
Even if you're solid on the legal issues in play, it might not harm you to listen to the advice of someone else. But
oh, here's another tactic. Oh, it might not harm you. What have you got to lose? It's being offered for free. If it was of any value, any real-world value, they wouldn't offer it to you for free. They'd charge you for it, right? They only have this crew of liars that they offer for free because those liars help you pay them. So any judge tactic where he's trying to be nice is bullshit.
You choose to follow it or not because it is your case. So for today, I think what we need to hammer out is one.
And by the way, this is what he thinks. He just said, this is what I think we need to hammer out. Well, that's nice. I appreciate what you think, but this is what the irrelevant issue is on the table.
Do you want to have the court appoint a lawyer for you? And if not, I would allow you time to...
He's already said he doesn't want a lawyer. And now the judge is going, I would allow you time to da-da-da-da-da. I would grant you an extension. I'll give you an extension. I'll give you an extension. I'll give you an extension. This judge wants out because Hero is kicking his ass. He's kicking his ass so hard, the judge's fallback tactic is to be polite from a judge in a measly traffic court equivalent. Wow.
Consult with counsel, private counsel, retained counsel outside of court, and then come back and make a decision about how to proceed. Because it is a big...
I might just edit this fluff out because our hero is not speaking up and he's letting him... Blah, 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 blah.
If you participate in community court, because what are you doing if you enter a plea even to a reduced charge? You've given up your right to contest the case
blah 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 blah
before a jury or a judge.
Stating the obvious, Captain Obvious.
Those are important rights that you would give up.
Stop wasting our time, please. Thank you.
Probably if you enter into community court. It might be that if you did so, it would be with a potential benefit that is worthwhile and that...
What a bunch of time-wasting garbage as the minutes tick by.
Would put you in the driver's seat about whether you would...
Oh, it put you in the driver's seat. See, you're the one with the power.
Retain that benefit. Following through with community...
Retain that benefit.
Community service. I don't know what the offer is.
Are these people all... Is Invasion of the Body Snatchers real? Have all these judges been implanted with alien overlords that are controlling their mouths? Because it's like they're all relying on the same training on how to manipulate people with various tactics of BS. It's hilarious.
But that's the way things stand at this moment.
Okay, first off, you said, I think, and then to preface all of this, and now you're saying that's the way things stand at this moment? Well, that's what you think how they stand at this moment. Where they actually stand at this moment is on the table. The relevant issue on the table is the only thing I'm missing in order to plead guilty and pay the fine and be out of here right now today is evidence of jurisdiction that's supposed to be submitted by the prosecutor. I'm beating this dead horse to death.
And Nancy?
Yes?
That was a lot of words.
May I speak? Perfect response, hero. May I speak? And then that was a lot of words. So he patiently waited to the end to keep his polite factor high. And that's another way to go about it. And that might be a more effective way to go about it than what I'm suggesting here. I mean, I'm saying things out of kind of like frustration, but that's not really, if I was trying to keep it nice, how I'd say it in court. Our hero is doing a really good job of keeping it polite because the judge is being really polite, which means he's not being threatened with violence and he'll be able to get relevant and damaging words onto the transcript. That's the name of the game.
I would prefer a summary of what he said.
I gotta take a pause to laugh. That was great. I would prefer a summary of what you said. He's like, that's a lot of words. I would prefer a summary of what you said. That's a perfect response to a bunch of blah, blah, blah. I wish I knew what was going on with the judge's head. He's probably, like, fuses are blowing. That was great.
But I still feel as though I'm attempting to be informed as to the cause of the hearing, and I have not been adequately informed.
Okay. The cause of the hearing, I'll say this in summary fashion one more time. And that is that.
As if he's already stated it once, and now he needs to say it one more time. He's going to get into circular logic, okay? He's going to go off on his Bush's distraction. And our hero is like, that isn't relevant. Can I get a summary? Because I would like to be informed. And the judge's response? I'm not going to summarize. No, I'm not going to do any of that. I'm just going to give you this one more time, the circular logic. And here comes a bunch of BS.
You are charged with two misdemeanor crimes, and that's what occurred in Sonoma County, and that's why this court has...
Objection, point of clarification. Judge, I've been listening very carefully to everything you've said. You don't need to clarify something you've already said. You don't need to repeat yourself and waste the court's time doing that. I'm asking to be informed as to the evidence of jurisdiction submitted by the prosecutor. Do you have a copy of it? Because I don't. May I have a copy, please? Yes or no?
Jurisdiction. If you want to challenge the jurisdiction of the court over this type of...
Oh, here we go. I'm listening. I'm listening.
...the case and are making a motion to that effect.
Oh, God. He just pulled out the tactic of, you need to, it's a motion. It's a motion. It's a motions hearing. Motions hearing. Nope, sorry, you can't bring that up here. That's for a motions hearing. I've had this done to me at court. Thanks, Judge DeCasse. Motions hearing. Bailiff, get him out of here. That's a motions hearing. I don't care. You can't enter verbal motions. No, that doesn't exist in my courtroom. That's a motions hearing. You gotta go to a motions hearing. Next case. Bang. Objection. Point of clarification. I am entering it now. Nope, next case. Bang. Bailiff. Right? That's all this judge is trying.
Saying that this court doesn't have jurisdiction over you, that motion is denied.
Am I presumed innocent of the charges?
Yes, you are.
Oh, what a perfect segue into proving what a lying piece of shit this judge is. What a perfect segue, hero. Here it comes.
Okay, and is jurisdiction an element of the charges?
So he just asked, am I presumed innocent of these charges? And the judge said yes. The hero said, is jurisdiction an element of the charges? The judge knows he's messed up right there. Messed up. The judge knows what's coming. Duh. Anytime you hear a judge say, duh, you just screwed him. Well done, sir. Well done.
The venue of the, whether the crime occurred in Multnomah County, that is significant, yes.
That's not an answer to the question. Who cares if it happened in a county and that's significant? That's your opinion that it's significant. That had nothing to do with what he just brought up.
For where the charge could lie. Is it?
Where it happened is not on the table. That's not even relevant. We are both in agreement of where it happened. I don't know why you're bringing that up.
Turns out it was really...
Well, I do know. We all know why you're bringing that up.
In another county, you could raise that and move for a change of venue.
why on God's green earth, if it happened in another county, would he even get a ticket to come to this county? That is a scenario that would never exist and has never happened. He would have got a ticket to another court in another county. Objection, point of clarification, do you think I'm a raging idiot that I'm going to believe such a... I mean, obviously I wouldn't say that in court, but you get the point.
Where the crime actually, or the alleged crime, actually...
Where the crime, or I mean the alleged crime, don't forget you're alleged. Gotta have the alleged in there, judgy. He knows that there's no presumption of innocence. He's 100% that he is guilty, and they just have to pretend that there's a presumption.
But as far as legal jurisdiction, I don't know what your challenge might be, but I find that...
As far as legal jurisdiction, I don't know what your challenge might be? The challenge is I need a copy of it. That's the challenge. I need a copy. I'm not challenging it because I don't have it. I need a copy. You see how stupid the judge is being? A lying, manipulative prick.
This court has jurisdiction over these charges.
And would you mind explaining where you find that or how you found it, what evidence you're using to substantiate that?
No.
The judge just says no. I'm not going to tell you what evidence I use to substantiate that I have jurisdiction. No. You're presuming jurisdiction absent evidence of jurisdiction. You're presuming jurisdiction without evidence of it. That's called bias. That's called, you know, you can give this up to a higher superior court and he's going to go, God, this judge is an idiot. He screwed this transcript up start to finish. He let this guy walk all over him with this and he looks like a moron. He looks biased on it. And this is totally grounds to get another judge, but even if he did, it would just be the same tactic, same crap from another judge. There's no... justice in trying to get another judge. The system is rigged. You cannot win in a court system without a fair and meaningful hearing. These are unfair, meaningless hearings. It's a rigged game. You cannot win.
Well,
you can't win by going through their way. You can win by going outside the box and by challenging jurisdiction. Obviously, that's what we're doing. And if you doubt me, send me a message and look at the video I'm about to upload with an April 4th dismissal of charges against me for the exact same thing. Real world, April 4th, 2016.
Explain any further than I have a number of times now, and that is that because you are charged with criminal offenses that are alleged to have occurred in this county, you're subject to the jurisdiction of this court.
That's your opinion. Where's the evidence of that? Do you rely on factual evidence? Do you rely on legal conclusions? Does this court accept uninformed guilty pleas? Because you're sure trying.
By state law.
That would really piss him off. Uninformed guilty pleas. Woo, that gets judges pissed off.
Point of clarification, who do you represent in this matter?
I like it. So now, our hero is segueing into a very appropriate sideline of clarifying, okay? He realizes that this judge is just doing circular bullshit, so he's going to get on the transcript another line of very effective clarifications that are a well-designed trap to show the bias, to show the unlawful criminal nature of what's going on in these courts. Thanks, Judge. Man, you're going to be teaching a lot of people around the country on how to deal with BS judge tactics that are nothing but lies. Thank you, sir.
I don't represent anyone. I'm with the circuit court.
I don't represent anyone. I'm with the circuit court. Objection, clarification. Are you saying that you represent the circuit court? And if so, who does that entity represent? This is a word game he's playing right here.
I don't represent either of the parties, either the state or you.
Objection, point of clarification. Do you have a law license that is issued by the state? Yes or no? Objection, point of clarification. What is the name of the entity that signs your paychecks so that you can cash them? It's the state of Oregon, motherfucker. You represent corruption. You represent tyranny. You represent theft, violence, and murder, ultimately, you and your ilk, your kind, your parasitic, leech-like behavior on society, Judge. That's what you represent, sir.